acoustic like fossils in the belly. You break open a rock and stuff is inside it. All of a sudden you hit one. It's got a beautiful bird inside. No one's ever seen before. Finding a bird is sort of like finding a fossil.
Right.
Interesting stuff. So, those are some new things I got. The documents were new. Of course, some of the letters I got, you start to put the pieces together. It's like a puzzle on the table. And Dave Martin is a very good thinker. He's a great thinker.
Oh, he is. He gets the details.
Oh, yeah. He figured stuff out that I didn't see. And that's why the more people that look at these things, the better. Because we all come with different experiences and different backgrounds and different information. And someone else can look at these photographs and say, hey, look, did you notice this or that? Right. Yeah, so they really need a lot of eyes. All these documents need to be looked at by more people than just the two of us. But we got it started anyway.
Right. And Dave wrote an article about this, and he said, when did fans start jumping on people and electrocuting them? Merton was lying on his back, his arms by his side, with a floor fan lying diagonally across his body. That's obviously set up.
Yeah, Dave said to me once, he said, it's far more likely to be murdered than be killed by a fan.
Right. Right.
And the fan was, the police report said there was some faulty wiring installed. The keyword is installed. That's what they said, installed. Merton had used that fan for several days without any problem. And of course, it is possible to get an electric shock. That probably has rust.
Sure.
But to get a shock from a fan that has a faulty foot installed, at the same time you have a heart attack, is, in the words of Dave Martin, it's sort of like getting struck by lightning and stepping on a venomous snake at the same time.
Right.
Not too flat possible. It's possible, but
not likely.
No, and Merton didn't have a heart attack at the moment that he was next to a coffee wired fan.
Right.
It just happened to be, it's a little weird. So those were some things we found, and it was kind of fun. There's a lot of stuff in the book. The book is available on Amazon, The Martyrdom of Thomas Merton. And we're getting a lot of positive feedback. We got a great review. I don't know if you saw the review by Edward Curtin.
Oh.
Oh, my goodness. Great. Yeah, great review. And we get email all the time, people put our website. We have a website called The Martyrdom of Thomas Merton. And it's all like an underlying word. I can tag it on The Martyrdom of Thomas Merton.com. But there's the documents. Listen to the book in the back of the book. I think here are six photographs. I'm not allowed to show you. There's the mugshot of me. But they're there. They're up to 35. But the book, we give a pretty detailed description of them in the book. We analyze everything for the reader. So at least hear what they want. Read what they want.
Well, and as you say, you can get a description of the book, you can look at the documents, articles, reviews.
Right.
So.
The book is at Amazon.
Right. Yes. And here, and you have the documents up here for a doctor's certificate with cause of death from the National Archives. That's fabulous. It's wonderful
you
that you've put...
You can print those, too. Those are public documents because they're government documents. So I was able to put those up on the internet. And people can look at them, they can print them and share them. But it starts the conversation because anybody who thinks Thomas Merton died of an accidental electrocution when he stepped out of his shower, they need to look at the tie documents because they don't say that. They don't say anything about a shower. They don't say anything about any accidental electrocution. In fact, the police report says that he died and the dead priest, would say, colliding with the fan when he fell.
Oh.
So according to the police report, he was already dead when he came in contact with the fan. And that's the official story. So...
Thank you.
Poverty is our strength.
Mm-hmm.